This is your Fox 47 News Flash.
Welcome to your Fox 47 News Flash from the Digital Newsroom. I'm Chris Lewis, and these are the top stories that we're following. It's every kid's dream to be friends with their favorite professional athlete, but for one boy in Charlotte, that dream is a reality. You could call it a long-distance friendship. The NFLer living in Dallas while Gavin Miller lives a few thousand miles away in Charlotte. But that doesn't stop the two from being each other's biggest fans. From Lansing Catholic to Kelly Short Stadium to AT&T Stadium, Dallas Cowboys quarterback Cooper Rush has risen through the ranks to play football on the biggest stage. But the mid-Michigan native has never lost sight of his hometown or the people in it. Rush's parents live right across the street from the Millers. The two struck up a friendship through proximity, but it quickly became more. Gavin has Perth's disease, a rare medical condition that causes the hip bone to disintegrate. Recently, Gavin and his family were able to cheer Rush on in person at the Cowboys preseason game when in town for a doctor's visit. The nonprofit Miracle Flights was able to fly them down free of charge. Michigan legislators announced proposals designed to protect workers, taxpayers, and legitimate businesses by reining in on payroll fraud, according to a press release. Legislatures introduced a series of bills that focuses on companies that cheat workers in order to avoid paying full wages, overtime, and taxes. Lawmakers say that the current system has gaps that allow fraud to go on. The new legislation would toughen penalties against companies that commit payroll fraud and give back wages and benefits to cheated workers. The State House has approved a resolution urging Representative Larry Inman to resign. The resolution passed almost unanimously. It states Inman's conduct has drawn ridicule and disgrace to the House and shaken the public's trust. The Republican from the Traverse City area faces federal charges over an alleged scheme to trade votes for campaign money. He was indicted in May and has refused to step down after being kicked out of the Republican caucus. A top Democratic lawmaker is calling Governor Whitmer's proposed 45-cent fuel tax increase dead. House Minority Leader Christine Grieg said that there are other ways to raise revenue without having to increase the gas tax by that much. Governor Whitmer has defended her plan, saying Republicans have yet to propose a viable alternative. State lawmakers have to come up with a budget by the end of September, or else the government will shut down. Learn more about all of these and all Mid-Michigan's breaking news on Fox47News.com.